Hey guys, Brian here. Welcome back to the shop. So, thanks to having some of the greatest viewers in all of YouTube land, I've got some goodies here that were brought up. They started off in Florida and managed to migrate to Keith Rucker's, and he held them for me for a bit, and then somebody else was able to bring them on the rest of the way to me. So that was very much appreciated. And this stuff is going to play a role in the cylinder head job. Sitting over here now, I've got another job on the mill I'm working on. So got it over here on the surface plate, ready to put it back together, but we've got those valves to address. So just take a look at what I got. It's a snap-on tools on the side, so you know that's gonna be something good. I know a lot of people say, oh, this is antique, you know, you can't use that, can't fix nothing, but that's okay. It worked in the past and it'll work again. So we've got is a snap-on slash blue point valve seat grinder, complete kit. The stone drivers are in good shape. Got a lot of pilots of various sizes and lengths. So I should have everything to grind valves, seats and the head should I need it. Got the dressing attachment. Set the angles on here. Use the diamond to dress your stone. I think this is actually the diamond dresser for the valve grinder. I just took it off and put it in here so it wouldn't get broke. So I got that part, although I don't think the seats in this head really need touched. They look to be in good shape. Supposedly the head was fully reconditioned when they got it, so. This is the other piece I got. This is a snap-on valve refacer. Says it's a VR300, made in USA. It appears to be a nice little machine, but needs some work. Been sitting for a long time. So I've already started working on it. I got the bearings out. And so what I'm gonna work on here now is getting the bearings put back in this. Thanks to the beauty of the internet, I found some 202K003 bearings that match the spindle that came out of here. So I'll put those back in. Also took the trash out. Hauled 2 truckloads of trash out of this shop, cleaned it up, got the extra motor out of here. Well, spindle's all cleaned up. Same bearings both sides. Do this long side first. Thank you. flawless for that one. Get all the goodies they had up in the back side of this thing. Our snapper ain't goes in last. And a pair of wavy washers. Use my Nipex snap ring pliers. These are good pliers. Best snap ring pliers I've ever found. Snap ring back in, squared side out, of course. Still turns, that's a good sign. Front side pulley. Tap tap. Well, before I put this side back together, let's see how this thing sounds. Pretty good. It's way better than it was. It's locked up when I first got it. Got ahead of myself putting these guards on. Well, considering it was squalling like a banshee when I first got it, well, actually it was locked up totally and it wouldn't even turn. I managed to manually pull the belt and get it freed up to where it would turn, but it was still really stiff. And then once I did get it going, it was squalling, burning for toast. Let's take a look at the most important part of this thing. Thank you. about 1,000 and a half run out. Insulation's cut. More than I'd like to see. Have to see if I can come up with a way to get that better. All right, so this is the spindle out of that. I may or may not have captured. It was getting about 1,000 and a half a run out. I feel like it's really too much, so I'm trying to do better. I'm just setting this up on these blocks. And then it came outside, I get like nothing. Remember, this is a tense indicator, so we're less than 0.0001 run out on the outside, so that's good. Problem is it's inside, and I've fooled around with this collet indicating and determined that I continuously get the low side here where I put this white paint mark. So let's see if I can show you up inside here. Can you see? Maybe somewhere. It's hard to get the light and I blocked the camera. Maybe from the other end, I don't know. Just looks like a big white hole like that, doesn't it? Well, as good as I can get it right there. Hopefully you can see there's some buildup on that side where it's showing low. So I'll try to go down in there and get that cleaned up. And perhaps that will improve the run out. Just got me a little roll of fine grit emery. I'm just gonna try and concentrate on rubbing on this one side. That ain't bad. It's less than a half thousandth right there. Let's check repeatability.
little more than a half thousand, about 7 temps. Let's see what's indicating low here, I guess. Still indicating the low about where the pay mark is. Now we're chasing after less than a thousandth here, so this is more Robin Renzetti's world than mine. That there's pretty good. It's less than a half thou. Unclamping it and reclamping it, still less than a half thou, so. Let's do a little more thorough inspection here. Find the low spot. Right there. Paint mark on. Paint mark as well. Let's turn it 180. That's close enough. Still less than a half thou. I guess I should check to see which way it's going here. So it pretty much shows the low side in line with the mark, so it means it's in the collet, not the valve. Don't say I like that one overall. It's like 3/10. Little spot still with the paint mark. Let's Here's where we originally checked it. That's a couple 3/10. Well, that's what you like to see right there, ain't it? Virtually nothing. And it's touching, so. Yep, a piece less than a half thou. Sometimes it's excellent like that. It's like nothing. I gotta decide what I'm gonna do about these bushings next. There's a got less than 1,000th play in that bearing. Maybe an actual split in half bushing with a screw to push it together would have been superior to this tab deal with the spring. It doesn't really offer enough resistance to deflection and taking up wear. Maybe Robin can weigh in on that. But I'm satisfied with the run out. That's looking a lot better, so. So, definitely less than 1/2,000. pretty good for a check.
Well, I hope you've enjoyed getting to see me go through this little spindle and get this thing running a little more true. Could probably be better, but it's pretty good. Less than a half thousandths run out repeat on a three-leg collet like that, I would say probably pretty decent. I know there's a lot of people that have VR collets that aren't even anywhere close to that good. So thanks for watching. Thanks for subscribing. I'll catch y'all later.